when we pursue how we develop the city to be more sustainable. Maybe it takes higher costs, like for the solar panel or wind turbine for the energy, renewable energy. But for the long term, it really saving lots of costs for infrastructure. So I think this is the challenge of changing the mindset. You cannot see city only for 5 years, 10 years. You have to predict the future at least 30 to 50 years. Number one is the issue of mixed use. In the future, hotel will be mixed with shopping mall, will be mixed with hospital, will be mixed with everything. When it happens, it's really the quality of life in between buildings that also matter. Number two, also the trend would be how urban design produces happiness. It's always my interest because happiness is really related to how the space in between building. So in Bandung, we transform no man's land, negative space into usable space and really changing the way people perceive the city. From the economic standpoint, it will always be a pressure to build more things. But sometimes, the best decision is not to build anything. In Bandung, we experiment what we call happiness projects. The advanced society is not always related to higher economical statistics, because at the end, the balance of physical city, the balance of intangible value like happiness, that will be the core goals to create a sustainable city, and that will be the goal for Bandung as well.